The sun is beaming tons of energy to Earth every second. But how do we actually capture that energy? That's where solar cells come in. They're like little sunlight-catching machines that turn light into electricity. Welcome back, Mr. Smart Family. Today, we're going to unlock the secret behind two fascinating devices: solar cells and photodiodes. Solar cells and photodiodes both work by turning light into electricity, but they're used in some pretty different ways. Let's break it down and see how they actually work. At the heart of every solar cell is silicon, a material we call a semiconductor. Why silicon? Because it's perfect for doing something special. It can absorb light energy and convert it into electricity. The silicon in a solar cell is actually split into two parts. One side, called the P-type layer, has these little gaps or holes where electrons can go. And the other side, the N-type layer, has electrons. When we put these two types of silicon together, we create what's called a p-n junction. Here is where the depletion region is formed. Have a quick look on our video about diode, where we have explained about p-n junction, depletion region, and working of a diode in detail. Let's get back into the topic. So now, the magic or science happens. When sunlight, made up of tiny particles called photons, hits the solar cell, they give electrons enough energy to break free from their atoms. These freed electrons start moving toward the N-type layer, while the holes move toward the P-type layer. This creates a flow of electrons, what we call an electric current. To capture this current, the solar cell has metal contacts on the top and bottom layers. As one tiny solar cell doesn't produce much power on its own, so we connect many cells together. We call this array of solar cells connected together as solar panel, which generates enough electricity to power lights, appliances, and even entire buildings. When the power requirement goes higher, or when there is a need for a mass power production, multiple solar panels are connected together. Once the electricity is generated, it flows through an inverter, which converts it from direct current, DC, to alternating current, AC, the type of electricity your home uses. From there, it powers your home or charges batteries for later use. If there's extra power, it can even be sent back to the grid. This is how solar cells work. Now, let's talk about photodiodes. They're cousins of solar cells, also made of a p-n junction with layers of silicon. But instead of generating electricity, photodiodes detect light. They're like the eyes in light sensors, cameras, and even your TV remote receiver. When light hits a photodiode, it frees up electrons in a similar way. But rather than generating lots of power, photodiodes produce a small electrical signal. This signal lets circuits know that light is present. That's why they're perfect for sensing rather than powering. So in short, solar cells are optimized to generate electricity, while photodiodes are built to sense light. Solar cells need to create enough current to power things, whereas photodiodes only need a small signal to tell other circuits that light is there. Did you know solar cells are the main power source for satellites in space, where they capture sunlight constantly? And photodiodes are used in so many devices around us that we hardly notice, like in remote controls, camera light sensors, and even in smart lighting systems. All right, that wraps up our deep dive into the world of solar cells and photodiodes. Now you know exactly how these tiny but powerful devices work and why they're so important in modern tech. Don't forget to hit that like button if you learned something new, and subscribe for more science stories. Thanks for watching and keep shining bright!